Oh, hey everyone, welcome aboard. I'll be your Captain Hillyan today, or tonight. And yeah, we finished with the base game of Warhammer 40K Dawn of War 2. And well, since we're still a bit early, we'll be moving on with Chaos Rising.
Along with me, Mighty Lieutenant Drakir, at your service.
Yeah. Now, it should just work if I click here, just to be certain I installed the other version of the game, though it did just install instantly, so I presume when I installed the, well, what on Steam calls just Dawn of War 2, that also installed Chaos Rising immediately, even though for some reason they are counted as separate games in the library still. But yeah.
It is tradition.
And a fun little thing that we can do, we can import a previously completed campaign here.
We should do that, shouldn't we?
Yep.
Only a year ago, the Aurelian sector was all but doomed. The hive ships of the Tyranids hung over each world, seeding them with obscene creatures. The Tyranids were ready to feast. But these worlds are also the recruiting ground for the Blood Ravens, a chapter of the Emperor's own Space Marines, and they refused to yield. The veteran Targus weathered pitiless alien attacks, allowing Cyrus and his scouts to find weaknesses in our ravenous foes, while Avitus leveled his righteous fury upon the Xenos. Thaddeus descended upon them on wings of fire. And Davian Thule, the first to fall against the Tyranids, returned from death in the form of a mighty dreadnought. You led them all, Commander. Together, you fought across the deserts of Calderas, through the jungles of Typhon, and beneath the great spire cities of Meridian. You faced an implacable enemy, and you triumphed. But there is a truth more implacable than any tyranny. A new threat will always emerge. Once, planet Aurelia was the sector's crown jewel, home to billions of souls. Then came the warp storms. They pushed Aurelia into a new orbit, encased the planet in ice, and swallowed it whole. For a thousand years, the warp held Aurelia in its terrible grip, depositing untold horrors across its surface. Now, planet Aurelia has returned. It should be a barren ball of ice. But a signal is coming from its surface. A Blood Raven signal. A call for help.
Armageddon and Retribution. Let's see. Once led his space marines from striking a cruiser Armageddon during the climatic battle of the Tyranid invasion, the Armageddon sacrificed itself to buy the space marines time to defeat the aliens. Commander Hillyan and his space marines now serve aboard strike cruiser Retribution, part of the fleet supporting the Blood Raven's third company. Many chapter serfs and valued relics were lost with the Armageddon. So I guess it's a good thing we handed as many of those over to the Librarium, huh? Unless the librarian was on board the Armageddon.
That's a nice side. Commander Healy. Actually, Hill?
Mm-hmm.
Don't get this get to your head now.
No promises.
I know Commander is higher than Captain, so try to.
Commander, this is Gabriel Angelos. We have detected a Blood Raven's distress signal coming from somewhere nearby. If there are chapter brothers in need, provide support. But be wary of a trap. Angelos out.
Our drop pods have scattered, Commander. Something is interfering with the navigation systems. We should locate our other forces and regroup.
Oh, thanks, here.
Before the cleansing begins.
We need to get past this wall if we are to locate the other drop pods. Use your jump pack to get across. Remote detonators and demolition packs are more than enough to bring this gate down. Let fly.
Okay, since this gate can be bought separately, it'll still give us a little... tutorial.
Supply crates replenish explosives and other expendable items. Destroy those crates to uncover the supplies.
Okay, this time though, they only refill singular things instead of one of each. So we're going to need these even more than before.
Alright, I guess a bit of balance.
Guardsmen, what are they doing here?
Hold your position, Space Marines. I said hold!
Lower your weapon, Guardsmen. We do not answer to you.
Gun them down!
Under fire. I can clear those bunkers with explosives. Attacking them with standard weapons takes much more time.
That's down fishy.
Okay, now we finally get to see these at work. Yeah, that's a big boom.
Something sinister is going on here. No loyal guardsman would ever fire on a space marine. I doubt these traitors were alone.
Not the first time... not the first time that...
More traitors ahead. And well-armed. My scouts wear light armor, Commander, so we had best make use of available cover. One step at a time.
Not the first time that the Imperium will have to deal with traitors, and certainly not the last either.
So in the last game was due to a chaotic influence.
Yep.
But and these could actually just be...
This planet has been stuck in the warp for 1,000 years, so I think they had plenty of time to convert.
Yeah, so these could be traitor guards.
No, the fact that they shot at them was basically confirms that.
The area is secure, but this unpopulated glacier is an armed camp. Did this world not just emerge from the warp?
If so, someone else got here first.
Traitor guardsmen. Just when I was starting to respect them.
Hate them if you will, but do not underestimate them.
Or that, someone could have beaten them to the punch.
Yeah. And they're probably using regular guardsmen outfit as disguises.
Get ready to fire!
Traitors.
Oh, Tarkus sending solo against them.
Well, Tarkus has their attention. We should engage them at extreme range and focus our fire.
Get crushed.
Sergeant Tarkus. The scum incapacitated Tarkus. Commander, use a stimulant kit to heal him from a distance or manually revive him.
My thanks, Commander. Our drop pod took anti-air fire on final approach. Only I made it out, and just barely.
And still, you made yourself a target to break that ambush. What would the Codex say about that?
The tactical squad shall draw the enemy's fire, thus allowing the Devastator squad to attack from a position of strength.
Ha! That it does!
This whole situation looks like a trap, but there is still a distress signal transmitting from somewhere nearby. We had best locate its source quickly.
Yeah, for as much as this, well, it is a trap, this trap could be baited with actual blood ravens. So as stupid as an idea it is to move forward, it is still the best thing to do. Okay, Cyrus, go capture that.
Standard Imperial Locator Relay. Transmitting a generic distress signal using Blood Raven's codes. Just enough to lure us in.
Coordinates 9.6 by 11.12. Launch barrage!
Artillery, clear the area!
Say it now before the cleansing begins.
A spotter called in that attack from hiding. Cowards.
Isn't that what we are for you, spotters? You are literally armed with artillery yourself, dumbass.
We should extract and bomb this ice pile from orbit.
No, we need to secure an approach before we can launch an extraction.
Only logic engines can track and target drop pods. Those systems depend on a broadcast array.
Then let us act like space marines. Find the array and destroy it.
Oh dear.
Grab as many of these as we can. Okay, full of medical supplies. Oop.
I can advance on that turret in tactical formation without being suppressed. Once in range, I can disable it with a frag grenade.
Okay, Tarkus.
Destination confirmed.
Okay, and he starts out now with the frag grenade as an ability, as an energy ability instead of a consumable. Yeah, there are quite some differences between the base game and Chaos Rising, if I remember.
I hope we get to keep the levels we brought over from the last save.
Well, level 19.
Commander, there is an orbital relay ahead.
Nice.
Securing it will give us a defensible fallback position should we need it.
It will also allow us to reinforce our squads. The chapter's recruiting.
Okay.
Without hesitation.
Yep. Darkness.
This will clear the mind.
Okay. Capturing beacons, frag grenades, tactical advance. Yeah. Basically, just a repeat tutorial for players who are rusty or people who never played the base game.
Move on to the next target, brothers.
Okay, and yeah, these have now been split up into medical supplies, combat supplies, and strategic supplies, as one was visible there. We'll have to see if they fill one of each or just run randomly when we get more of them.
Spotters, open fire! Return fire! Return fire!
Let them fall before us!
Okay, the fact that we have our levels should give us quite a buffer for being able to deal with these a bit more recklessly.
As you lost, we forgot to add the new levels before we joined here.
Yeah, I think I leveled them all up as much as was possible before the last stand.
Well, didn't we get new levels during the last fight?
Yeah, we got equipment, but we'll have to see if that carries over.
Sounds like a bit of French accent or something?
It sounds a bit French-sized, yes. Wherever that artillery is going, it's not anywhere near us, so that's a good thing. Okay, just keep pushing. Darkers, grenades. You just capture that for a moment. Okay. Give them a house welcoming gift in the form of a very, very, very hot potato. And they liked it all so much they ran outside.
Oh dear.
And threw themselves out the windows.
This isn't as any normal traitor guards, but they are, just as if they're any special ones.
Unlikely.
Usually get to see them in animations and hear what they're in order. But only recently got in some official units. Most of them are to crush them.
Let's see, this is a very squeezy choke point.
You know what kit bash means, right?
Yeah, to slap it together from parts from different sets.
Good boy, okay, good captain.
That target.
Okay, Avatus, tear this thing down. Yeah, that's going to go down quick enough. I was about to send Cyrus in to plant a bomb in space. But no, this thing is fragile enough. Come on.
Thunderhawk is en route.
Then we should proceed to our extraction point and destroy any other traitors we find.
Okay, now... You pull back.
You need to go down the stairs. You need to go down the stairs to reach that.
Yeah,
Oh wait, there's just the up there. Remain
vigilant. Parkers go this way here. Yeah, we can go down this way. Yeah, everyone here and this way. This is the path of least resistance.
Destination confirmed.
Okay, that's better than going all the way around past like three bunkers, probably filled with traitor guardsmen. I think there's at least one known traitor guards platoon or whatever you'd call it. That's also supposed to be the ones that show up during in dark tides.
Oh! And they are destroyed.
I forget their name, but they're supposed to be canonically just having been neglected and abandoned by the Imperium.
We're exposed here. Watch for an ambush.
Which is why they turned traitor, because well. They were forgotten and left to fend for themselves for who knows how long. So it's a bit understandable as to why the hell they were turned to chaos. And okay, it does refill one of each. Hallberg of Fate. I think our we got something named similar to that.
Yeah, in Hope? Yes. True to the Hallberg of Fate, though.
Cyrus, big shot that way. Tarkus, give him a dessert with a grenade. Okay, that was a very flat statement of one of them there. More corpses.
God.
Say it now before the cleansing begins.
Avitus under attack. Avitus, we are their doom. Destroyed.
Okay. More of them.
Hostile forces spotted.
Target acknowledged.
Okay, they probably should have moved into cover a lot earlier than that. Okay, you capture everyone else. Prepare to bunker down. And now they have grenade launchers.
Of course.
Took out one of Cyrus's scouts.
You should expect a counterattack shortly.
Agreed. Still, this is a defensible position. We hold here.
Set up firing position there.
Unarmed Talon Alpha inbound. Hold position.
Let fly.
My Devastator squad should take position in that structure. this whole area will become our killing field.
Okay. And because of this, this has... will that work better? Like last time we... They were rather limited in their firing angles.
The traitors are laying down a barrage to soften us up. Prepare for an assault.
Okay, everyone inside. Okay, Imperial Guard artillery is very powerful, but it's also very inaccurate, as you can see.
Oh, it works just fine if you're dealing with Tyranid hordes or hordes.
Yeah. Okay, Cyrus and the scouts are holding out over there. I just remembered that I didn't actually check to see for difficulty, though. So I'm guessing it imported the difficulty from the imported save.
No idea. Also, what kind of god running with pistol and swords?
Dumb ones. Navazus hasn't fired it. Okay, there he's fired his shots, but... okay. Okay, Cyrus, pull back from there.
One of our initiates has fallen.
There. Let's not have our first mission end with someone dying and getting us a lower score. So you also get out and just start throwing grenades everywhere. Yeah, we're going to deal with big swarms quite a lot sooner here. Can you fit in there as well, still? I still see some open... Yes, all four of them fit into the same big building, okay. Though we can't tell them to focus on any targets now, so that is one downside. And Avatar's Leech is level 20.
Another barrage! Return fire, brothers!
Down, next target.
Yeah. Okay, so gotta hold out for 140 more. Okay. Cyrus, get out for a second so you can get your squad refilled. There and back in. Okay. Carcass. Now this focus fire. Pardon? Okay, this is a bit annoying that it doesn't select who I'm actually clicking on when they're in a building together. Did I just hear Wilhelm scream in the game?
I can click it.
I'm not surprised they choose to add that to the Guardsman for...
It's a very Guardsman sound.
Yeah, I want to use a full Stormtroopers.
Here comes Talon Alpha.
Good job, you missed the most of them.
Breaking off the attack. What do you expect from traitors? Courage and honor? The reward for treachery. Retribution.
Yeah, that comes after this one, Avatus.
Victory is but a prelude to the next battle.
Cold welcome, a very fitting title. And we get a new weapon.
A granny? What? What did I get granny from?
Okay, I'm guessing you were trying to shorten grenade launcher, but you made it sound like you were sending grandma into battle.
Oh god, that's more worse than what my fear was. Like, something like a Harry, but... A gallery, but... Oh, good gods.
A granny launcher. Oh, fires miniaturized grandmothers to beat the enemy's ass with a purse. Okay. We've got two levels, and we've got some new toys. The Hamburger Fate, set to glow warmly on certain feast days. This power armor was born by the Blood Raven Adrian when he defended the Abbey of St. Irene against the Black Legion. Suffering terrible wounds, Adrian... we've had this one before. Okay, ooh. So if you trade these in, you can find them again. That's assuming that we kept the war gear that we had before. Okay, and just a basic grenade launcher. Astartes pattern...
Only Cyrus can use it.
Yep. Lobbing miniaturized fragmentation grenades over intervening obstacles, the grenade launcher is effective at disrupting massed infantry. It may also fire a payload of blind grenades, stunning enemy forces.
Well done, Commander. Those guardsmen have paid the price for betraying the Emperor. We must discover who these traitors were and how they came to use a Blood Raven's code. But we will have to investigate that later. The second strike team I assigned to investigate Aurelia has sent a distress signal. Sergeant Thaddeus and his assault marines are already prepared to deploy, along with the dreadnought Davian Thule.
This signal could be another trap, Captain Angelos.
This call is a full message, Sergeant. Review the signal on your planetary display and provide whatever support you can.
And also, I just realized... Go ahead.
A full message. All right. Eldar?
Yep. And I just realized a bit of a mistake, or rather a bit more of a gaffe or a joke. During the scene with these ships at the end of the base game, the smallest ship were the escorts. The Armageddon was actually that big thing in the loading screen's middle, I'm pretty sure. Okay. And, this has been quite expanded, huh?
Yeah, and look at the loot!
Okay. Yes, okay, so we did get to keep all that we had before, and even some more things. And this now has been changed to something a bit different, huh? Okay, and some of these we just get from the game itself. The Helm of Command, plus 25 armor rating, 20% sight range, and 10% accuracy to user and all nearby. Okay, this would be really good for a ranged force commander.
Let's gear these people up. And why does Fool have a speaker icon? I mean, Thaddeus.
Yeah, because we can have a chat with him. He has additional information about the troops who attacked you. Yeah, this is also something new, huh? But yeah, as you can see, these have been expanded quite a bit, and I'm pretty sure that if we click here, we would get back all of the points that we put in before. Click to reassign the combat discipline points for all of your squads. This option is only available now and will be disabled upon return from the next mission. So yeah, if we wanted to, we could redistribute all of this.
Let's be happy with what we got.
Yeah, let's have a little bit of a look first. Okay. Yeah, we'll have to check these over some other time, but I think for the most part, everyone will be about the same. Yeah, tactical mastery, volley, which frag grenades equipped. Each use throws a volley of three instead of a single. Okay, that would be good. Yeah, I think for the most part we'll leave their...
Oh. Commander, I recognize the markings on the troopers who ambushed you. They used Imperial Guard equipment, but those were House Vandis forces.
Vandis, the deposed governor. That coward fled the sector when the Tyranids attacked.
The noble houses on Meridian have their own militias. It looks like Vandis's troops are resisting the new regime.
I am sure Governor DeRosa will be delighted.
Okay, the audio mixing on that was a bit off.
Yeah, but that governor ran over his own private army, and now they're attacking us. So they're not chaos cultists then. They are just...
Yeah, traitors. But the difference between a traitor and a cultist in this universe is very little, or very thin.
Okay, we need to give him... Wait, why doesn't he have his special armor on?
Let's see, I believe some of these did get changed up a bit. Oh, because his equipment got moved around a bit. This isn't what he had before. So he doesn't have the plus two that makes him venerable.
Yeah, let's fix see.
Yeah, that's the one that gives it, but we also have this here. Venerated Seal. Let's see. 4% movement speed, not much. 25% chance per hit to... Have another 25% chance to heal yourself and all nearby. Okay, that's 25% of 25. That's like 12.6% chance to heal. Okay, so then again, it's extremely rapid fire.
Yeah, more damage than the other one. So,
what we can do is give him this one.
Yeah.
It's a firing skull mouth.
Oh dear.
I hope. We'll just get him venerable on the next level up then.
Yeah.
Because I don't know if this will reset everything for everyone.
Yeah, but if it did everyone, that's the problem. If it was only for per character, wonderful. But for all of them?
Yeah, that would be a bit of a nuisance.
Yeah.
Ooh. Sharing his mastery of camouflage, Cyrus extends infiltration to nearby allies when his squad is not moving. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, this would be a good point if you'd want to to try something different, to just put a save up here. And just, scramble whatever you would want to try out, like, go with the... make your force commander completely melee or ranged if they were the opposite before. But for now, we'll just stick with it as is. Let's see.
Then you armor with a new framework around it.
Yeah, that's the blighted armor and power armor here.
Oh. All right.
Yeah, because this is a redemption item. And you'll see what redemption is about later. For now, let's just focus this. Let's see, no written term. Okay, we had that before, but I think it was from something that gave a boost to that. Let's put the other point here as well.
Yeah.
Tarkus.
Yeah, Vic. Mm-hmm. I said this, Vic, before next mission, we need to gear up everyone again.
Yeah. Let's see. Not enough points to give anyone something new. Let's see. But Tarkus and his squad become able to equip chainsaws and bolt pistols. Yeah, we don't want him in melee. We want him in range. So let's keep going up his health. Thaddeus. There. Let's see. After taking a large amount of damage, Thaddeus can enter a reckless state, stretching his abilities to their limits. During this time, abilities cost no energy and have no recharge duration. But he needs to take a lot of damage before then, so he might be on the brink of death then. Put the rest there. No levels for Davian, so sadly he is still hanging behind. Avatus. Attack range attacks increase in damage the longer he remains stationary. So let's go towards that. And Cyrus. Cyrus deals significantly more damage when he is away from allies. Normally that would be pretty good, but the split up, well, splitting up in this game is about as smart as splitting up in D&D. And well, we all know the rule with that, don't split up the party.
Oh dear.
So let's instead work up his energy and then a bit more in his ranged. Okay. 120 damage, a bit faster in attack, a lot less accuracy, but actually reaches farther away than the sniper rifle.
Wait, what?
Yeah, by only 2 meters, but still. Let's give him that. Okay. Let's take a bit of a look around with everything here. Fist of Valhalla. That's a new one. When orc freebooters established a hidden raiding base on the frozen world of Typhon Septimus, the sector governor called on a detachment of the Imperial Guards Valhallan Ice Warriors to root them out. A single squad of Blood Ravens also deployed, despite the governor's wish to exclude the Space Marines, whom he distrusted. Valhallan Colonel Otterson, however, welcomed the aid and formed a bond of respect with the honored warriors. At the end of the operation, with all the freebooters dead, Otterson gifted his personal power fist to the chapter. Okay, must have been the previous governor, who, well, we know plenty about now. Hmm.
Valhallan Ice Warriors, yeah, I have seen those.
And we can't use the Terminator arm at the moment because they're damaged.
So, what did you do?
It's been a year. They've been fighting plenty of, and probably it's also been just completely soaked in acids during the Tyranid fights.
Oh, true.
Because they were cleaning up after those for quite a while. Let's just quickly give some stuff that should be better. This will be good against traitors and elder alike, I presume. Give you that. Give you that. That's quite a bit more damage. Thule. Yeah, give you that. And you still have that one. Now, you have no reason for suppression resistance because you are unsuppressible. And let's see, 2 rocket launchers, a normal one, and the Lament of Mars. Lament of Mars actually deals more damage. But let's keep the team as it is at the moment. Okay, why did you point me to that game? Yes, this game also has co-op. Okay.
Strike Cruiser Retribution. This is Librarian Jonah Orion. We are under attack. The Eldar are massing around us. They have a Wraith Lord, which has already claimed Sergeant Endymion. We must drive these Xenos back.
And also something new is that we can now help react to certain things. And Thule has something to say about this.
All right.
Brother is correct, Commander. We must recover Endymion and Jonah and exterminate the Eldar.
Yeah, okay. And...
All right. I like this.
Yeah, it adds more character to them. Let's see, what are the Eldar doing on Aurelia?
We found them excavating the area. To what end, I do not know. The Eldar have deployed a powerful force to ensure we do not find out. I fear we will not survive long without reinforcement.
Okay. And we start off with bonus intelligence. No need for common rays this time.
Weapon.
Let's see. Elder walkers and grav tanks are present. Use anti-vehicle weapons. Elder structures have been detected. Explosives will be ideal. Okay, right. So...
Yeah, didn't you have a rocket launcher or something?
Yeah. I don't know if Thaddeus is required. Let's... Okay, we can't swap out, so we don't get a choice. We get Tarkus, Thaddeus, and Thule for this. Okay, Cyrus, hand those over. I know you like your bombs, but we are going to need them if you're going to be sitting up here instead. Get those along as well. And let's see, anyone has anything else that we could use here? Actually, this is grab those as well. Oh, right. Only Cyrus can use these. You can have those back. Keep you company whilst we do actual work.
Yeah, remember to give Thaddeus his missile launcher.
Yeah, it's not Thaddeus. His Avatus is the one with the rocket, but he's not coming along.
Oh, come on.
So, yeah, we are rather limited in what we can do. Actually, we have the Meltas still somewhere, right? Right? Yeah, Thaddeus has those, okay. Then Tarkus, you take this. Make you a bit more hardy. And...
Strike cruiser retribution.
Okay, it will just repeat it. Okay. Librarian Jonah Orion. The Space Marine psychers known as librarians are able to manipulate the fabric of the warp itself. They are both powerful warriors and lore keepers for their chapters. Jonah Orion has served under Gabriel Angelos since the aftermath of the Tartarus campaign. During the Tyranid invasion, he was one of the psychers tasked with battling the mighty hive mind as Captain Angelos made for subsector Aurelia. Of the dozen librarians, navigators, and astropaths accompanying Angelos, only Jonah survived. So yeah, he was the last one who was getting that last message across.
Eldar warriors, attack!
Okay.
How can we serve? Give the word.
Let's start with getting rid of that.
Away from him, you Eldar wretches!
Quickly, secure that beacon!
Marcus.
I think this is going to be the last mission for today, and yeah, we are closing in
of
ending the stream.
There. Okay, now get rid of that one. Thaddeus captured the points. Okay. Still would have been still a little annoyance is that they still let us pick up the supplies even when they won't be of use. Thaddeus, focus that thing down. Tarkus, grenades. Bombs.
Eldar witches, get back!
No more blood ravens for this day.
No more!
Still a bit of jank with in-game cutscenes.
You are a welcome sight indeed, Commander. I am Jonah Orion.
And Endymion?
He fell, saving me from an Eldar war machine. We had just discovered a large Xeno structure to the east when they attacked.
A webway assembly, no doubt. It will allow them to invade at their leisure. We must destroy it.
Go. I will guard over our brother's remains. The
Of course. I am at your disposal, Commander.
Yeah, with that, Thule leaves us for the moment.
Attack formation, brothers.
And yeah, we get our own Psyker. Nice. Use Thaddeus, and we send over the Force Commander. Okay. You get in there. You smite. Now, if I recall correctly, Jonah is very powerful, but he's also very fragile. So in a way, he is sort of like Cyrus in that way. Ooh, Thaddeus is taking hits hard.
Well,
they're
really not a class cannon, but something with that line.
Falling back to next position.
Okay, everyone pull back. That was a bit more than we could handle.
Take your position, brother.
Okay. Just regroup, reinforce, and recover.
Oh dear.
Okay. Also something to note, during the intro cutscene, when it was talking about that distress signal, I'm pretty sure they were using the noises from the listening posts from the first game, or from the first Dawn of War. But yeah, it's a bit unfair of the game to put us up against vehicles and such without giving us access to the specific anti-vehicle units, or the heavy weapons units. Like, yeah. Thaddeus can also function as it, since he comes base with the melter bombs come with him. But still, it's a bit...
Aerial assault, go!
Yeah, but I'm so early on when it comes to the mission, I was to ask why that is. But it's not even like a bad design. Rather, a very forceful way to make it harder for you. Like, you should be able to choose, but you're not allowed to choose.
Yeah, it's to make you get used to Thaddeus and Thule as well. Just drop in there. Okay, everyone recover. This shouldn't take too long, despite a bit uneven odds, but we'll see how things go. Okay, yeah, like I said, Jonah, he is a bit of a glass cannon, but he can be really powerful if you spec him well. And that was a flash grenade. Okay, Thaddeus, go get him. Force Commander, go after them. Yep. Could have also thrown over a grenade, but I will. Would smite have worked with that? Without the line of sight, I don't think so.
Target destroyed.
Okay. Let's keep going on. I think we might go a little over our usual end time, but not too much.
But is it end times? Oh no!
No. Wrong setting for that as well.
I don't know, it's...
Something akin to a Wraith Lord.
There is a end time in 40K as well.
Okay. Let's get rid of this first.
We got each other's flanks.
Okay, I don't actually know how wide of an effect these things have, but it's better to be rid of these beforehand. Okay. Rest of you, move this way. Okay. Darkers, you know the game, a hot potato, and... Okay, that creature that was half of Jonah's health gone in one hit.
Holy!
Yeah. Like I said, glass cannon.
Okay, I was correct about calling them a glass cannon earlier. I was thinking we described him. Oh wait, we're still describing librarians in general. We expect a... That armor to handle the Eldar.
Engage by Eldar!
I say, I'll aim at his face. Oh wait, no, he will get out of the death right now.
I'm pretty sure he took a fire prism shot or two to the face there, so that also explains it.
Ooh. Yeah, that will do it.
Tactical squad, moving to that.
Okay, pick him up. Someone capture this, and then we can push out into the encampment.
My powers are yours to command.
Okay. And yeah, he can also work as a healer. Okay. Jonas, stay at the back line, please. Okay.
Psychic power is building up.
Quickly, destroy their access to the webway.
You are too late. The ancient souls have found their new homes. Rise, race god. Destroy the humans!
Okay. Jonah? Oh, well, that was rather easy. Okay.
Preparedness is all.
Deal with those gates,
eliminate
quick. Because of that. Jonah? Pull back. Thaddeus. Disrupt the ranks. Thaddeus needs more energy. Don't move.
It is done. Move on.
Don't Eldar spare. Answer their attacks with holy fury, brothers.
Darkus, quick. Actually, ignore, get that gate. There's a bigger one there. Okay, there. Yeah, it's a good thing that we imported higher level, huh?
Yeah.
Because I believe otherwise you get started at level 15. Thaddeus got stuck. Okay, he managed to get out. Okay, quickly get that thing down before more spawn. Rutgers, move up.
Eliminate that target.
Thaddeus, forwards.
Assault squad repositioning. Hit them hard. Give that a shot. Fast.
Okay, not what I wanted.
Ready.
Okay. Need some more supplies because we're out of explosives. Medicine also works, but it looks like they can't actually spawn from that. Yeah, my big mouth.
Yeah, this bullet. How slick we just said that they came in. Off.
They cannot retreat.
What were those things the warlock summoned?
He called them Wraith Blood. They somehow drew psychic power from it.
The Eldar pressed their attack.
Captain Thule, hold fast. We must support him, Commander.
And now we have problems on both ends. And hey, Pyro, doing pretty well, I'd say. And you? We finished off with Dawn of War 2, and so we got... We got an early start on... on Chaos Rising. Which is the quote-unquote expansion slash semi-sequel. And yeah, basically what's going on is that a planet that's been stuck in the warp for a millennium has been spat out, and somehow there are Blood Raven signals coming from the surface.
They must require a warlock support.
And yeah, we found a surviving librarian here. So yeah, a thousand years in basically hell, and he still managed to get out alive. He wasn't stuck here. He came along with the Blood Raven forces because he was the last survivor of that. So yeah, almost had it wrong there.
Oh dear. Oh yeah, hello again, Pyro. Oh,
dear
gods.
Okay, we are going to end the stream after this, though, since we've passed our usual 2 hours.
Yep, and it's getting late.
Fine work, brothers.
We're being chased. Okay. And yeah, in the meantime, they've recaptured some of these here. I don't actually know what... If there's consequences to Thule, okay, he's self-repairing as well, it seems.
More of them!
And with a warlock this time! Kill him to weaken the Wraith Guard!
Okay, now we lost sight of which one it was.
My power is ours!
And the skills here.
Assault Marine team, held up! Close and engage!
Okay, just throw a satchel in their midst. Okay, at least that disrupts their position by forcing them to move. Yeah, he is smart enough to move away from those. There. And yeah, this game has a lot of the typical 0.5 edition stuff going. Like, there's more interactions with the characters, more equipment and stuff that we can do, and while the level cap has been raised quite a bit, I believe. But yeah, now we need to rush back and take care of this thing before we lose our blasted dreadnought.
Oh.
We started one campaign by losing Thule. Let's not have it become a second. Okay. Though it seems that he took care of it mostly himself still.
Now, Endymion shall rest.
Zeal and fury are rewarded with victory.
Okay. We get the Claw of Zeal, which is a lightning claw. It's another new enemy, not enemy, weapon type. Okay. 100%. 3 or 4. I think we left some stragglers, but if it'll give it, I'll take it. Okay, and Thule gets his level, the Force Commander gets a level, and we get some new equipment. Litanies of Vigor grants energy to all nearby allies, replenished by medical supplies. By reciting the chapter litanies, some basic armor. Blessed of Solivas? Yes, Solivas. successful kill and heal nearby allies for 15, recover 15 on hits. Okay. The death of an enemy of man is a balm to the soldier's soul. From the teachings of Solivas Benjamin, High Confessor of the Monastery World of Latin Tertius. Okay, some base armor and the claw. Lightning claw gauntlet edged with the with blessings of zeal, guiding the wielder to take strength from the blows he delivers up unto the enemy. Okay. Yeah, that was the Armageddon.
The Eldar return to the sector could not have come at a worse time, Commander.
As you suspected, the House Vandis militiamen who ambushed you at Argent Glacier were not an isolated band of malcontents.
Okay.
The Vandis rebels have risen up against Imperial authority on Meridian. The Retribution will take you there to provide support. Governor DeRosa will have further details for you when you arrive.
What of Planet Aurelia, Captain Angelos?
Jonah, I'm reassigning you to the Commander's Strike Force. You will all return to Aurelia once the crisis on Meridian has stabilized. Angelos out.
Okay, some lines there were obviously recorded in a different date, a different setup.
Yeah.
Okay, but with that, yeah, that's our start on Dawn of War 2, Chaos Rising. And yeah, things are going to be a bit more interesting than Tyranids are coming, go kick them out. Though that is a big oversimplification of the story of the base game, but still.
Good gods.
And for now, we're going to look for someone to raid. So let me change the screen share there. Change window, Twitch, live. Okay, it seems someone's been pinging me or something. Let's see, quite a bit of people online. We have Slooptube with Dark Souls 3, Corodust with Bokura. It's, I know there's some anime with that as a character name. Freaking KFC. A burger. Everyone is getting into the chicken nugget scenes and pushing in on KFC's, you know, the territory lately. Okay, it seems they're doing another co-op game with Blanks.
Oh, it's that game you saw them play last time, maybe you checked them out. That you should have a different view or something.
Yep. Next we have Schwalbe, who is playing Darkwoods. Grim the Wolf is playing Walkabout Mini Golf. Isn't that a VR one version? Yes, it is. they're playing VR Halloween golf.
Oh, dear.
I'm a Flanker is playing Ready or Not. Jimmy McGinger is playing Crosscodes. Still on our to-do list. Once we're done with LA Noir with Rom, I'm going to talk with Liz about what times would be good to stream Crosscode with her joining in. Smoops Other Nonsense is playing Guild Wars 2. Big V streams Baldur's Gate 3. Tatsuki Tale, Silent Hope. I think they played that recently as well. It sounds familiar, but I don't remember much of it. So it may have been that they were playing that. Oh, hello. WBPL is streaming The Lord of the Rings Return to Moria. Okay, I didn't know that that was out yet. From what I know, this is basically if you took like Return to Tarkov or something, or it's basically a survival game, but in Moria. Don't know how much of it is really resetting or such, or if it's more persistent like in Terraria or such. Would be very interesting to see that. But let's continue on. Last but not least, we have Halloween with Stalker Anomaly. Okay, I think I can guess who you'd want to raid.
And they called it a mine. A mine!
Okay. Copy the name, slash raid and paste. Apparently I hit caps lock somewhere. Okay, but before we start that, of course, thank you everyone who has been watching now or later. Thank you Pyro Sue for visiting and chatting along a little bit. And thank you Sensei for lurking. And as always, thank you to right here. What is my throat all of a sudden?
You always forget my name or something?
That's something with my throat. I think I need freaking water.
No problem, but yeah, you welcome as always, my friend, and thank you all for joining.
Okay, and I specifically took one of those throat candy things before stream to try and prevent stuff like this, but seems that's not going to work much longer. Okay, so yeah, let's see. I asked if the others are interested in trying something multiplayer tomorrow. We'll see, or yep, I probably got a reply from one of them at least on that with the pings. So we'll see about that. Nothing sure.
I might not be able to join it in the afternoon, maybe. I need to go away for a bit in the afternoon.
Okay.
But the evening, no problem. Otherwise, yeah, I will let you know once I return.
Okay, we'll try and set something up and see how it goes. Good chance that there won't be anything, but yeah, that's how it's been. Okay, and yeah, Thursday we'll be continuing with Chaos Rising, and in the weekend we will continue with our side projects with Deadbolt and Mythargia. And yeah, we'll see how that goes. But for now, yeah, let's get that raid started. And thank you all again for watching, and until next time, have a nice day, and until then.
Be safe, everyone, sleep well, and watch out for undead seagulls.
And chaos seagulls, especially.
Thank you for that mental image.